Hello everyone and welcome. Today I have a very special video for you guys. My unboxing video of the PS4 Pro, which arrived yesterday via Amazon. And I'm so excited to finally have it in my possession. And I decided to make a unboxing video for you people out there who would like to see what the new model from Sony has to offer. Actually, I had to wait pretty long for the console to arrive at my house because on Amazon Germany it was out of stock for like I think like 3 weeks. I waited for this one, and today is like the 21st of February, which is, by the way, I think Valentine's Day, I believe. So anyway. It arrived yesterday at my post office and I picked it up because I wasn't at home. And yeah, I'm so glad it's finally here. And I even picked up free games for it. This one here is Bloodborne, the complete edition. I will do an unboxing for this one in my next video. Awesome PlayStation 4 exclusive game. Highly recommended if you are a fan of the Dark Souls series. Definitely grab this one up. Then I got this is Resident Evil Origins Collection, which include the HD remasters of the GameCube classics, the remake of the first Resident Evil game, and Resident Evil Zero, I believe. Excellent game. Picked this one up today here at my store. I thought since I got Bloodborne like 2 weeks prior by pre-ordering the PS4 Pro, I got this one, and I thought I need two more games to play them. And I also have this one on Steam, or both games on Steam on the PC. Excellent game, I highly recommend it as well. We'll do an unboxing on this one as well. And of course, my favorite, Resident Evil 5. I have this game on my Xbox 360 as well, the gold version. On PC I have it as well, and since I picked it up for like 25 euro, why not? I think I love this game, it's very great and always fun to play. So yeah guys, those are the three games I got. Those two I bought today, Resident Evil and Bloodborne. I got 2 weeks earlier for even pre-ordering the PlayStation 4 Pro. Okay, but in this video I will deal with the games in my next videos. In this video I will unbox for you the PlayStation 4 Pro. This is how it looks like. It comes in this well, slightly big box. It's not so heavy as I thought it would be. I mean, the package, I will show you around. There it says PlayStation 4 Pro. I will go into detail what the difference is between the regular version and the Pro version, and of course the Slim. And I think the gamepad or the controller is slightly modified from the previous model. It has of course a 1 terabyte hard drive, and as far as I'm concerned, I heard that recently Sony has released a patch which will allow you to connect a external hard drive, PC hard drive, up to 6 gigabytes of memory or hard drive space to your PS4. And this is excellent news, which means you can just hook up a external hard drive finally on your PS4 Pro, because games are getting very big. All those next-gen graphics have to fit somewhere, and you know, it's always nice to have lots of space on your console. So I will show you around the package. Looks like that. There it says PlayStation 4 Pro. Here on the side we have also the logo, nothing special. I will unbox it in a few moments. There it says PlayStation 4. At the back I think we have advertisement for some games, mainly Call of Duty, I believe. Yes, Call of Duty, Infinite Warfare. Then we have here Uncharted 4, this one was released. excellent game. If you have a PlayStation, I highly recommend you get Uncharted 4, because the Uncharted series, much like the God of War series, is Sony exclusive, pretty much like Bloodborne as well. So here we have The Last Guardian. Last Guardian also is a PlayStation exclusive game and only available on the PS4. So you can't play this on other consoles or even the PC, sadly. And of course, Horizon Zero Dawn. I believe this game will release this month in February 28th. I could be wrong, but this one is also a game I look forward to play. It's made by Guerrilla Games, the guys who also made the Killzone games for the PS4. Also, yeah, another franchise you only get on the PS4 is the Killzone franchise. And of course, Call of Duty Infinite Warfare, it got very mixed reactions. I have it on the PC, and honestly, together with the Call of Duty 4 Modern Warfare Remaster, and I didn't play it so much. It's your typical Call of Duty. Basically, if you played one or you played Black Ops 3, it's basically the same. And here we have a picture of the PS4 Pro. You get in this package, you don't get any games. All you get, of course, is the console and the gamepad, and I think some cables. The games I bought separately, of course. So this is not bundled with those games. This is just advertisement, just so you know, people. The box just comes with the console and the gamepad. Okay, guys. So I will do the unboxing now, show you the insides, and show you around the console. So inside that big blue box over there was another big white box, which contains, of course, the main console, and there is the gamepad over there, together with the cables, and of course there are some quick installation manuals, I believe, and I think other pamphlets. Yeah, this is the quick startup guide, so nobody ever reads those, but they're in there, right? So here we have the gamepad with the cables, and let's put this aside for a moment, like down here, and let's have a look at the actual console. Well, it came very securely. I'll put this aside like that. And let's see how heavy it is. It's actually not that heavy. And actually not that big, or it doesn't seem to be. Let's put it aside. Okay. I thought it would be a little bit bigger, but kind of secured in those things over here. Let's put it aside. And yeah, guys, it's actually not that huge. I believe it's slightly bigger than the original model, or on par with the original model, and very similar to, or a little bit bigger than the slim version. So here it basically is. This is how it looks like. Comes with a very nice matte finish. It's not glossy, which I actually like, because some consoles tend to be glossy, and it's annoying because you can see all the fingerprints all over it. And yeah, this is how it looks like. Let's take it a little bit and show you the back of it. Comes with a very silver shiny PS4 logo. Let's set it up vertically. This is the back of it. Looks very cool. And here you have your standard Blu-ray player, which I heard can play normal Blu-rays, but to my huge surprise, or for everyone's surprise, it does not play 4K UHD Blu-ray, which is a bummer since this game, or not, this console was designed to play games at 4K resolution, but I will talk about that later, because it's actually 2K, which is downscaled, but it still looks very impressive. So here we have your Blu-ray player. Over here you have two USB 3.0 ports, so you can put in your gamepad and other devices. And there it says PS4. It has a very nice matte finish, as you can see. On the side, let's check the side. Looks like that. Nothing special over there. You have your ventilation system here. And let's take a look at the back. Let's see if I can remove the wrapping like that. Let's move that aside. Right. So, yeah. Put that away. So, let's have a look at the back. At the back we have over here a connection for your power supply, or it has the power supply integrated. You just connect your power cable over there. It's like a regular, you know, PC kind of power input. Then you have your USB, or not, this is HDMI, sorry, my bad, the USB is over there. You have your HDMI 2.0, I believe, which is a step up from the previous model. The slim model had only a 1.4 HDMI input, so there you have your input for your VR. Then you have optical audio over there, and of course the Ethernet port, and very nice, a third, it's over there, a third USB 3.0 input, which is very nice. So let's put it down. What else is there to say? Yeah, it's a little bit slimmer than I thought it would be. This is my very first PlayStation 4. I don't own the original one, and I don't own the slim version. This is brand new. I never play. I'm not so much of a console gamer. I have a Xbox 360 and a Wii, and of course the Dreamcast, which I unboxed for its anniversary. But aside from that, pretty much looking forward to play some PS4 games, and especially this one here, since I'm a huge fan of the Dark Souls series. And this game here is made by From Software, the creators of the Dark Souls series, and pretty much looking forward to play this. And this is an exclusive for the PlayStation 4. So, yeah, pretty much looking forward to play it. Yeah, so that's about it. It's a very nice looking console. Matte finish, very slick looking. I think it's even a little bit smaller than the beefy Xbox One. And as you can see, it looks very nice. Let's take a look at the gamepad of it and how that one looks, because you also get the gamepad with it. So, but not the games. The games I bought separately, of course. Let's dive into this package here. Here we have your, I think, your connector for your power cable. This is like a regular PC power cable. I think you can even use it on PC, or it's similar to the ones used on PC, so you get that as well. And over here, what's that? Oh, nice. This is, seems like a USB mini connector. I think this one you will need to charge up your gamepad. And what else do we have? Okay, I think the gamepad itself. Have a look at the gamepad. I'm actually a fan of the PS4 gamepad. I think it looks very nice. Also, see, I know some people prefer the Xbox 360 gamepad over the PlayStation designed gamepad, but I always like the PS gamepad. They are really high quality. Let's see if I can take it out. Alright. So what do we got here? Okay. So those are some earplugs, but I bet they're really bad quality. Those are the standard PS4 earbuds, but you can use them if you like. I think it even has some micros, but honestly, if you're going to play with a headset, get a high quality headset. But okay, nice for a Sony to include those. Don't have power set, let's put that aside. It's all it's in there. And also very nice, the package comes with a HDMI cable. I already have a ton of these, but it's nice from Sony's part to include an HDMI cable, which will allow you, of course, to connect a standard digital monitor like this one here to your PS4, or if you have an HD TV like mine over here, you connect an HDMI cord directly through the PS4, and it will transmit digital video and audio. So awesome for Sony to include this one. And of course we have the gamepad over here wrapped up, and the gamepad, it was slightly redesigned from its previous iteration. Here it is. Oh, feels very solid, very nice. As you can see, I think the thumbstick have a lighter tone and were redesigned. This button over here, the PS button, as you can see, it lights up, was redesigned as well. And the D-pad has those small little arrows over here. Overall, it feels very good. It's very high quality, very premium. Also, the shoulder buttons are very nice to touch. A very well designed gamepad. Also, it has a very rubbery feel to it, and it's not glossy, it's very good. The touchpad is also very nice. A very high quality gamepad. Very, very nice. I highly recommend it. If you play this on PC, I think there are ways to connect this one to the PC, and it just feels very good in your hands. I have rather not large hands, but it feels very good. It's very high quality. So the gamepad itself, only one gamepad with the console. So if you want to play two-player games, get another one. But so far, this is what you get in the dot package. Very impressed with it. Also very impressed with the gamepad. Very nice. I'm looking forward to play those awesome games over there with it. So I will hook it up on my screen over here on my PC monitor. Also later on, I will do it on my big TV. And of course, I will have a look at it. As I mentioned much earlier in the video, the PS4 Pro was designed to output games in 4K. As you can see, here is the comparison between the regular 2016 version and the PS4 Pro. Sony said it boosts 30% higher speeds and higher image quality because it downscales 2K to 1080p, and some games received patches for it to make it look better, like Uncharted 4 I heard, or I believe Tomb Raider as well, Rise of the Tomb Raider. So yeah, anyway, I would highly recommend it. If you are completely new to the PlayStation scene like I am, definitely get the Pro model. From the price, it cost me 400 euro, $399 on Amazon. And yeah, it's definitely a little bit more expensive than the slim version, but offers the gold standard for the PlayStation right now. So if you are new to it, definitely go get it. If you own already a model like the Slim or the very first PlayStation 4, don't bother with it unless you have a very high quality 4K TV and you like PlayStation a lot. But honestly, just buy it if you get it brand new, or if you are new to the scene and want to play some exclusives like Bloodborne or Last of Us or I don't know, Uncharted. I never played PlayStation before, or you want to upgrade from the PlayStation 3 to the PlayStation 4, definitely get it. If you just want to play games, the previous two models are just fine. So yeah, about the gamepad, definitely huge surprise at my part, it feels very good. But having in mind I skipped the PlayStation 3 completely and never, and the PS4, the first two models as well, I can't compare it too much, but I'm very impressed with the gamepad. It feels very good, it's nice to have, and I'm looking forward to play Bloodborne with it. So yeah guys, that's about it. I thank you all very much for watching. Please like this video, subscribe to my channel for more related gaming stuff and unboxing videos. I will unbox in my upcoming videos the games I have for the PlayStation 4. I will do some streaming on Twitch. Also follow me on Twitch if you like to. I'm playing a lot of stuff lately like Resident Evil 7. What else? Berserk. I think Berserk got released today. Berserk and the Band of Hawk. I have to check that one out. Also the DLC for Resident Evil 7 was released yesterday or today at I believe 2 hours ago, and of course I will stream Bloodborne, Resident Evil 5, Resident Evil Origins, which includes Remake and Zero, and I'm looking forward to a lot more of PlayStation 4 stuff like Last of Us, God of War 3 Remastered, what else? All those awesome games you can only get on the PS4. So guys, I thank you everyone a lot for watching. I wish you all a good day, a good Valentine's Day over there for you guys in love. And I see you guys next time. Everyone, take care. Bye bye.